Hey guys! So this video is going to be a little different than my other videos. Instead of covering a scientific paper, I decided instead to make a video in honor of International Women's Day. And in this video, I'm going to address a question that I get asked sometimes. And that question is, what is it like to be a woman in science? And that's a tough one, right? Because I only know my own experience. I don't know what it's like for everyone. But for me, most of the time, my being a woman and my being a scientist have nothing to do with one another. And those are the best days. But there are definitely days where I get talked over, or I get something explained to me, even though I'm there as the expert in that topic. It's what you might call mansplaining. And I'm definitely guilty of saying sorry when I'm not actually sorry at all. It's just kind of an automatic response. I say sorry to myself, I say sorry to my cat. And I'm guilty of also saying that I was fortunate to have something happen to me, which doesn't indicate what is actually the case, which is where I worked really hard and I was really dedicated and I have skills in that area. Fortune and luck has nothing to do with it. And sometimes these little things that I do to myself, like saying sorry or saying I was fortunate, or these things that others do to me, like talking over me or mansplaining, they get heavy. Sometimes they get so heavy that I think to myself, I can't do this. I can't be a scientist. I can't juggle my career and my family and my friends and my whole life, and how could I ever think that I could do that? And then I snap out of it, you know? I realize that there are people everywhere doing exactly that. There are women all over the world, and they're not saying sorry. And they're not saying they were fortunate to get into that circumstance. What they're doing is they're having their career, they're having their family, they're having their friends, they're having their life. And that's incredibly inspiring to me. And one place that I expected to get some inspiration, but perhaps not as much as I actually got, was an event that I attended recently. And it was a Women in STEM Leadership event. And you might expect that I got the inspiration from the women that were STEM leaders, but in fact I got the inspiration from the students, the attendees, that came to the event. And I was probably more inspired by them than I was inspiring to them. And like all of the events that I go to, I had them draw on my whiteboard. And usually I give a prompt, and that prompt is something like, draw something that you know from science, or, you know, draw something small, like through a microscope. But this time, I wanted to be inspired, and I wanted to see what the future generations think of science. And so I asked them to draw like a girl, because I hate that phrase. I hate the phrase like a girl, because it is one of my greatest fears that I'm going to do really well in my career, be at the top of the science field, and have someone say, well, she did a really good job for a girl. I want to smash like a girl or for a girl into tiny, tiny pieces and rebuild it into something much better. Because I know that girls can run the world, and that the qualifier, like a girl, doesn't actually mean anything. And so to end on a positive note, I want to show you some of the drawings and some of the things that the attendees of this event said, and how much they inspired me. Some of the drawings that I'm going to show you are some of the funniest or most serious, most inspiring, or just the most wonderful things that I've had drawn on my whiteboard so far. So I hope you enjoy it.
I drew a girl with blue hair because it's always good to be different.
A girl reading a book about science. Me drawing a picture and a girl saying, wow.
I drew myself hitting a baseball.
Crew oars, because that's my new spring sport this year.
A forensic pathologist.
A scientist.
I drew a computer with a program on it.
me painting my nails. Some girls playing volleyball. So that's me doing things that people thought I couldn't do as a female and as a black girl.
Couple is two women, just got married, they're in love.
A lab coat that says my name on it.
A picture of like what I want to do as a dream job, so I want to be a game designer.
The world, Earth. From above it might look extremely small, but down here we have to make the most of what we have, and that's what girls do. They work for what they get, and they pass all these societal expectations and limitations from their gender, and they just go above and beyond what they ever thought they could do.
Brave.
Empowered.
Amazing.
Fearless.
Powerful.
Unstoppable.
Unique.
Creative. Interesting.
Girls are smart, they are successful, and they are beautiful.
Thank you so much to the New York Hall of Science for inviting me to your Women in STEM Leadership Night. I really, really appreciated the opportunity. And thank you to all of the attendees at the event that drew on my whiteboard and that talked to me and that inspired me. The future has never looked brighter, in my opinion. I hope you guys liked how I took your drawings, and feel free to subscribe to my channel for more science updates. I'll see you guys next time.